The Rode PodMic is arguably one of the best budget dynamic microphones on the market, but how does it hold up long term? I've personally owned the Rode PodMic for over 6 months, and I believe I can give an honest and accurate opinion about this microphone, as well as share my personal experience with the Rode PodMic. My name is Jaden, and on this channel, I tend to stick to product reviews, posting once a week on Saturdays at 12 o'clock. So if you guys are new here, consider subscribing. In addition, I do stream on Twitch, so if you have any questions about anything I talk about in this video, I'd love to answer them on stream. The Rode PodMic has tremendously risen in popularity over the last few months. With the pandemic, thousands of people started streaming and thousands of people started creating content, and with that, people were looking to buy an audio setup or upgrade their current one. And the Rode PodMic rose to popularity partially because of the fact that it was a budget-friendly mic, coming in at only $100. This mic was a steal to pick up. But the real question is, how does this microphone perform long-term? To clarify, this is a dynamic microphone that will work with any XLR audio interface or mixer. Now, when many people look to pick up a new microphone, they're typically buying the microphone because of the audio quality. But what a lot of times people are buying a microphone for is the looks. People want their microphone to look good on camera. And while it may seem surprising, a lot of people do it. As for the looks of the Rode PodMic, to be honest, I really like the design of it. It has an all-metal design that's super sturdy and very well built. The microphone is very, very heavy, so keep that in mind. When I first bought the Rode PodMic, I had to get a new mic arm because I was using a cheap $15 mic arm from Amazon. And right when I attached my Rode PodMic to my boom arm, it started to weigh down the boom arm. So make sure you pick up a solid mic arm, such as a Blue Compass or a Rode PSA-1. Staying on the same topic as boom arms and microphones, the microphone has a diameter that can fit almost any boom arm you put on it, or a mic stand, which is really, really helpful, so you don't have to go out and buy an external adapter to connect your mic to your boom arm. Now, setting up the Rode PodMic is as easy as plugging the XLR cable into the microphone and then the other end into your audio interface. My first audio interface that I used was a Scarlett Focusrite Solo 3rd generation, and this audio interface worked perfect for me. But I recently upgraded to the GoXLR Mini. Since I'm a streamer, the convenience of the GoXLR Mini is unmatched, and the fact that it had built-in EQ just makes this microphone sound 10 times better. To simply put it, dynamic microphones work best when you're talking directly into your mic. With a condenser mic, it's going to tend to pick up more of your surroundings, so beware of that. I really like the sound of a dynamic microphone. I like how it has this podcasting sound quality. It's really deep and rich, and that's something I really like about it. Now, out of the box, the Rode PodMic sounds pretty good, but one thing that I've noticed is that it lacks a lot in the low ends. So by simply making some adjustments to the microphone, you can definitely make this mic sound 10 times better. Inside of the GoXLR software, I use 3 different adjustments, but these will work the same if you're using filters inside of OBS. The 3 that I use are noise gate, EQ, and compressor. Now, when it comes to noise gate, I didn't really have to touch this. Since this mic is already a dynamic microphone and it blocks most of the outside noises, I just touched it a little bit and moved the knob up. Now, when it comes to EQ, I watched plenty of videos on how to EQ it properly, and I probably didn't do the best job because I'm no audio pro, but EQing your mic makes your mic sound so much better. It definitely adds a more rich and deep sounding to your voice when you're talking into your microphone. And lastly, I added a compressor because when I'm live streaming, I tend to get pretty hype on stream if something crazy happens or I hit a crazy clip. So I added a compressor to make sure that I'm not peaking on stream. And that's it. I really didn't have to touch this microphone. Out of the box, it sounds pretty good. Now, a very common question that people ask with the Rode PodMic and the Rodecaster Pro is, do you need a cloud lifter? The short answer is no. This microphone will work perfectly fine without a cloud lifter. If you don't know what a cloud lifter is, basically, when you plug in your microphone, you plug it into the cloud lifter, and then from the cloud lifter, you plug it into your interface. And what this does is it adds a little bit more gain. Typically, you'll buy a cloud lifter with a very popular mic such as the Shure SM7B, because the Shure SM7B is naturally a quiet microphone. But with the Rode PodMic, you don't need it. The only time I'd recommend picking up a cloud lifter is if you're a naturally quiet person when it comes to talking. The cloud lifter will help the microphone pick up your audio a lot better. And if you try to solve this problem by just turning up the game, you may notice some fuzziness in your microphone. And that's why people buy the cloud lifter, so it doesn't add that fuzziness to your microphone. There are plenty of great things about this microphone, but one thing that bothered me a lot about this microphone is how it handles plosives. This microphone does have a built-in windscreen, and that was something I was very hyped when I bought this microphone, because I didn't want to add an external pop filter that just wouldn't make the microphone look good. But that's one thing that this microphone just doesn't do well. If I use the classic Peter Piper picked a peck of pickled peppers, you can notice that the microphone just doesn't handle plosives well. An easy fix to this is picking up a $15 windscreen off Amazon. I will leave a link down below in the video description below for this product. I picked it up for this video, and because I was interested to see the comparison of what it sounds like without this on and what it sounds with it on. This microphone does not look good with this on. It looks just like, it's massive, it's huge, it's like in your face, and it takes up a lot of space on your camera. But I'm gonna be doing the same test. Peter Piper picked a peck of pickled peppers. And as you can tell, if you go back and watch when I did it without the windscreen, massive difference when it comes to plosives. So if you're somebody that's just a naturally loud person, or you tend to have like a more of a harsh voice kind of, then you might wanna pick this up because this will help with blocking plosives when you talk. As for my personal experience with the Rode PodMic, I have not had any problems with this microphone. It's held up very well and it's been a very reliable microphone. Speaking about reliability, the cool thing about Rode is that if you register your microphone, you can get up to a 10-year warranty with this microphone, which is super, super cool. This microphone has been consistent, I haven't had any problems with it, and I would highly recommend it. The best part about this microphone is for only $100, this is an absolute steal, if you can find it in stock. With it rising in popularity, it's going out of stock almost everywhere. So I'll leave a few links down below in the video description below if you guys are interested in checking this out. Even if this microphone was $200 or $300, I still would recommend this microphone. And if you take a look at a very common microphone setup amongst big streamers on Twitch, a lot of the times they're using a full GoXLR and a Shure SM7B. And to get an audio setup like a GoXLR Mini and a Rode PodMic costing less than the Shure SM7B itself, that's an absolute steal. And that's why I would highly recommend this microphone if you're new to XLR microphones or you're looking to get an audio setup for your live stream or content creation. With that being said, I hope this video was helpful for you. And if you did go on to enjoy, don't forget to leave a like on the video and subscribe down below. And with that being said, thank you so much for watching. I will see you guys in the next video. Oh, yo, what the heck? Oh, that was nasty. Can we get a clip? That flick was disgusting.